thanks go out to them today and to all who are working day and night to deal with the disaster. So much of our government was built to deal with different challenges from a different era. That's why I'm not going to let up in my efforts to reform our healthcare system, to give our children the best education in the world, to promote the jobs of tomorrow and energy independence by investing in a clean energy economy, and to deal with the mounting federal debt. That's not how we deal with challenge. That goal is why I fought so hard to negotiate a new and better trade deal with South Korea, a deal with unprecedented support from business and labor that will support more than 70,000 American jobs. A deal with a distributor in Brazil has resulted in new sales and new employees at that firm. You're wondering how they deal with an unexpected expense if their car breaks down. So we need folks in Washington, the people whose job it is to deal with the country's problems, the people who you elected to serve. We need them to put aside their differences to get things done. I never believed that the best way to deal with the housing market was to just sit back, do nothing, and simply wait for things to hit bottom. This week, I called members of my cabinet to the White House to deal with a challenge that affects so many families and communities: the crime, the outrage of sexual violence. It doesn't deal with the conditions that led people to criminal activity in the first place, or to return to prison later.
And I believe that President Calderon has used enormous political capital to deal with this issue.
I know what it's like to see a loved one who's suffering, but also having to deal with a broken healthcare system.
We are going to have to deal with our long-term debt.
There are lots of exploitation in workers that we can deal with in terms of how the jobs are structured, how the grants are provided, and what the government's role is. And
so I will deal with Congress and the courts as co-equal branches of government. Secretary, he will ensure that America keeps faith with our soldiers, increasing their pay, increasing child care, and helping families deal with the stress and strain of war. People of Zimbabwe need very concrete things. Schools that are reopened, a healthcare delivery system that can deal with issues like cholera or HIV/AIDS, an agricultural system that is able to feed its people.
We have to deal with these issues.
Doctors across this country did not get into the profession just to be bean counters or paper pushers, but more and more time the doctors should be spending with patients are spent on administration and worrying about how do they deal with how they're reimbursed. We don't have to deal with hurricanes, and we don't have to deal with floods, and we don't have to deal with fires. All we have to do is pass a bill to make sure that the American people have a decent shot at getting the kind of choice and high-quality health care that's affordable.
We are going to be taking steps as part of reform to deal with expanding primary care physicians and our nursing corps. Some members of Congress disagree with that, and they've got other proposals. And that's going to be worked out in September. I do want to make the point, though, that I have not proposed any plan that would put the burden on middle-class families in order to deal with this.
Take one example. We've agreed to work together with the Organization of Islamic States to eradicate polio. Something that we've been able to successfully deal with here in the United States, but still has an impact on populations throughout the Muslim communities around the world. And so we all understand that this is an issue that the country is ready to deal with. Maybe ways to deal with this bilaterally, but also potentially multilaterally.
Karen Mills, our outstanding administrator of this Small Business Administration, Sheila Bair, who's been doing a heroic job trying to deal with the banking situation as chairman of the FDIC, Mayor Michael Nutter of Philadelphia, and my national economic advisor, Larry Summers.
We've got to deal with that short-term issue.